How to install Windows 11 with only a local account. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is something that Microsoft keeps basically trying to stop us from doing, hence this update video. The technique that I used to suggest to do this stopped working. So we have another technique. I'm going to walk you through an installation of Windows 11 and set it up with only a local account, no Microsoft account involved. We begin, of course, by booting from the Windows 11 installation media. Now, I'm going to fast forward through a bunch of stuff that's going to happen before we get to the point where we need to do something different. Okay, this is where the magic starts to happen. What we just saved you from was watching 5 or 6 minutes worth of the setup process doing its thing, copying files, rebooting at least once, those kinds of things. This is where we now take some odd steps. At this point, before you proceed, hit Shift F10. That will fire up a Windows command prompt. Enter the following command, oobe /bypassnro. There's no space in there. It's all one string, oobe /bypassnro. We'll hit enter and the machine will reboot. Now it looks like nothing happened, but something important did. There's one more thing we need to do, and that is disconnect this machine from the internet. Now, depending on your system, you may have the option of just pulling the cable, which is certainly a valid way to do it. However, even if you don't, there's another technique that works. Once again, we're going to hit Shift F10. And again, this fires up a Windows command prompt. This time we're going to type in ipconfig /release. What this does is it basically releases the hold the Windows has on the internet connection. It basically forgets what IP address it's been assigned and is essentially disconnected. Now we can close that window and carry on. Again, this is the right country, United States, for me. This is the right keyboard layout for me. No, I don't want another keyboard layout. No internet. Excellent. That's exactly what we want. I don't have internet. Click on that. Continue with limited setup. And now we can set up our local user account. My local user account will be L-E-O-N. I get to choose passwords for it. It insists on having security questions if you're doing a local account. So we're going to skip this in the video, but I will have given it 3 answers to 3 questions in order to make progress. Now, with that in place, the setup continues. I'm going to go ahead and just do the turn off all of these privacy things just because. Remember to scroll down to see them all and hit accept. And here we are in Windows 11. Now, you'll notice that the start menu basically doesn't have a whole lot on it. There's a lot of places for icons, but no icons. And in fact, you'll notice that the icon down in the taskbar for your network connection is disconnected. There are a couple of approaches you can take here. I recommend simply rebooting the machine. That will, since we used the ipconfig command to disconnect from the internet, now it'll reconnect. If you've physically disconnected from the internet, make sure to make that connection now. We'll go ahead and type on in. There's my local account. I have signed into this machine with only a local account, and now Windows Update will slowly, presumably, do its thing to bring your system current. And in fact, it's already filled in the icons in the Start menu. But that's it. You now have a machine running a local user account that is administrator capable, since it's the first account created on the machine. Until Microsoft comes up with a way to prevent this from happening, this is probably the easiest way to create a Windows 11 machine with only a local user account. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/167438. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.